Hi, I'm Lori, and today I'd like to show you how to paint a beach on a mini canvas. All the art supplies that you will need, you will see here. First, you'll need the reference photo, a mini canvas, two types of acrylic paint, titanium white and carbon black, three types of paint brushes, one flat knife edge brush, two detailed brushes, one finer than the other, a palette to mix your paint on. I recommend Masterson's Stay Wet palette, a cup of water, and some paper towel. So I've covered my canvas in titanium white and I've let it dry. And now I'm going to mark out where the beach is on the painting with a very light gray. And I've just mixed that by mixing titanium white and a little bit of carbon black. And I'm just gonna mark out the half of the painting that will have the beach on it. Paint's a little thick, so I'm going to add a bit of water into my little pile so it goes on smoother. I want a nice straight and thin line on my horizon, so I'm going to use the wide flat edge of my brush to do that. And when I painted the white on the canvas, I painted all in this direction, in the horizon direction. It's important, I think, with landscape paintings to do that. So that marks it out. And then don't forget to paint around the edge to finish it off, because it looks so nice in its little easel at the end when the edges are finished. So I'll do that off camera later, but just wanted to show you that that's important. So that was my wide knife edge brush that I was using. I'm going to switch now to more detailed brush. Just got a few bristles on it, not too many. And I'm going to block in the trees on the horizon with pretty much, really, really, mostly carbon black and a little bit of white. So I'm just looking at my reference photo and I'm trying to pay attention to where the light shows through the branches, and that's why I'm kind of being a bit particular. I'm actually trying to keep the white showing through at the top of these trees here. And there's kind of like a bunch of branches crossing over, but there's a lot of white showing through right there, so I'm just trying to be really careful around that particular spot. I'm letting the roughness of these bristles just help me make really rough boilage. And then making sure to leave those white spaces where the sky is showing through. So this top edge is the most important edge for the detailing, and then I can just fill in the rest pretty quickly. I'm just trying to get the perimeter in nicely before I go to the filling in stage. And now I'm rolling my brush in the paint and using some water to thin it down to make a cleaner edge, because I've got a little tiny island to paint back here. And I might use my detail brush, my really, really fine detail brush, to fill that in, but it's going to be about that area. And then there's some rough trees on top of it. Pushing up on these rough bristles to help make my trees in the distance there. use a bit wider brush to fill in those trees. Just coloring. Fill it all in. Except for the white spots that I wanted to purposely leave through. A bit more connection here that I want to show. Use that flat edge of my brush to continue that nice straight edge. If I paint too much of the sky out, I can always paint it back in with white. So I'm probably going to have to do that. There's some interesting trees that are supposed to be right here. Some space between that and the island, so probably going to have to move that island over. So I'm just going to take some straight white and make some space, paint out this island right here, because I have these, there's an arbutus tree that I really want in the painting that's supposed to fit right here. And actually I think I'm going to paint this back to leave room. I think maybe I'll put one of the trees here and the other one right there. So this island has to move way over. So just paint the white, kind of using it as an eraser, and then I'll let it dry before I start painting what I really want to be in this spot. So I'm just going to turn the camera off for a second and let that dry. So I've painted over the island with some white. It's mostly dry. Needed a couple coats. I'm being really particular because this is an actual place that I visit and I can recognize the tree line. So you don't have to be so particular if you don't want to be. But I really want to make sure that this interesting arbutus tree is in my image. So it's just a bunch of foliage with light showing through, with sky showing through. And then I'm going to put some really little wisps of branches in a second. But first, I'll fill in most of this. And then it looks like there's a fir tree or a cedar tree right next to it. So it's more of a, it's got more of a point at the top. And with some more detailing, these trees will stand out a bit more. And I go to my really, really fine brush to do near the beach. Goes down like that, meets the beach. And there's some rocks and things at the bottom. And this is the brush I'm going to use to do a few branches, so just a few straight strokes so that you can tell that this has branches peeking through. It's amazing what a little tiny bit of stroke can do in how your eye catches that there's a branch in the distance there.
probably being a bit too picky, but I'm really trying to make this look like an arbutus tree. Sometimes I can overpaint, and then it's better to just leave it. I do a few little light gray strokes back here, just a couple. Now I'm going to go into some pretty light, I guess medium gray, where I've just mixed about half and half titanium white and carbon black, and start putting in some of the highlighted foliage on the shoreline here, just so that you can see a bit of interesting detail. I'm going to darken it a little bit. It's a little bit too light. Although, don't forget, acrylic paint always dries darker. So even though I thought that was too light, it'll probably be just right. So I'm just going to put a few little smudges there to show that there's a nice, probably a blackberry bush or something in the foreground of that area. And with this smaller brush, I'm just going to do a little bit more up in here. Just put that in a little bit more in a couple spots. Make these a little bit more meeting across the bush there. I'm being very particular. You don't need to be. If you want to do this painting really fast, you don't have to do all these little things that I'm doing. And this one, there should be some light poking through up here. And not quite so much down there where I put it before. There should be some interesting little flecks of some light dancing on that part of the bush. A couple here, some up there. Showing the rocks down there like that. So yeah, you just need to put in just a couple little paint smudges to give the indication of rocks on the shoreline there. This could be a little lighter. And then I have to fix that island that I kind of tried moving over. Move it over a little bit more. And it would be a good idea to do this island, even though on my reference photo it's just as dark as the other part. If you can make it lighter, if you make it kind of a medium gray, it looks like it's receding off into the distance more. So I'm going to do that, add a bit more medium gray. So it's kind of disappearing off in the mist in the distance. Some little treetops up there. This is more of a tall edge over there. Okay, so now the fun part. The reflection of these trees, which is why I wanted to make sure that they were in my image. There's a beautiful reflection of them on the beach, on the glistening water down here. So I'm starting with one type of gray, and then when I see it darken to the color that it's going to dry at, I can decide whether or not I want to darken it some more or lighten it. I'm just kind of doing this odd shape that I see in the reference photo. There's a all of this is reflecting on this sand in a really neat abstract shape in gray. So I'm just looking at that abstract shape and I'm literally trying to repeat it. This brush is not the best brush for this, but it will work. I'll just make it work. So I'm really just trying to repeat that shape on the reference photo, including what's going on the edges, the fact that these ones are not quite touching right there. This should be a bit wider and having some little bits sticking out. And then on the rocky shoreline itself, there's like a bunch of pebbles. So I'm just going to kind of do a line of stippled paint. To show the pebbly shoreline. It's kind of glistening in some areas, but it's also just looking like dry pebbles in some areas. So I'm using the roughness of the end of my brush to just kind of stamp on those pebbles in a line like it shows on my photo. And paying attention to how dark and how light the line is. There's, for some reason, there's a bit of a dark line right there. And you can't see pebbles, but you can see a line right here as well. So just be very careful to put a light touch on the canvas to make an impression of what's going on there. Might be nice to have a little bit darker paint right there. Stipple, 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 stipple. And then there's like a gap between another kind of row of pebbles here. Try to indicate that. This reminds me of pointillism. I remember doing an exercise in elementary school where we had to draw only with points, with dots. You just have to rub a really light touch and just try to do the dots really lightly, as close together as you can make them without making them too thick. And then I'm going to come through and just darken like kind of linear chunks just to connect some of them. That's what it looks like it's doing in the picture. And there's like some, must be a piece of driftwood or something. That's right there. And even, actually what I'm going to do is take a really, really light gray and mix in, kind of do some lines back here on the shore. It's drier up here and it was reflecting the light a little differently. So super light gray. And I noticed that between those pebble rows that it's lighter gray there. The water's reflecting differently on that part of the sand and this part of the sand. What's going on here? So the same here. It's The sky is brightening up this part of the sand more than the rest, so I want to make sure and mimic that. Helps the reflection to look more real. You've got brighter areas, darker areas. And over here, it's a brighter area as well, I see. I think I'm going to move to my other detailed brush. This one's a little bit too fine. Yeah, so this whole area has to be a lot lighter. So I will just work on that. There is a beautiful wave going on right about here. So I'm going to have to go back to that little tiny brush just for a second to just mark in parts of that wave so I don't cross it. And my brush is wet from cleaning it. Just drip some water on there. Okay, so I just need to mark that there's going to be a wave in this area. It's crashing, breaking right here. And that's kind of border of something that's something different is happening on this side of the wave than on this side. So we just have to mark that out right now before I go too far. Paying attention to the shape of how it's crashing and where it's thick and where it's thin. Okay, so I'm going to leave that, go back to my other fine detail brush, and start brightening up parts of the water right here. It goes right up to that boundary. Like that, and it makes that reflection pop a little bit more. And inside here, it should be the reflection of the sky showing up on this part of the water. And it kind of fades into this area here. But on this side, it's just nice and reflective of the sky. Like that. I'm trying to go in the general direction of water always is level, so I'm trying to make the lines level, if that makes any sense. So now I'm gonna put a few more little fine little flecks of rough water, I guess, little remnant of a wave right here. The wave before this one. It's just finishing its bubbling effect, like that. And then just a couple like whiter little flecks in here. shoreline must have been a bit wetter as well, because it's reflecting more than the other parts of the painting too. Okay, back to this detail brush, and I'm gonna do a few swirly wider strokes in this area. Try to blend them in a bit. Maybe use some of that water that's on the canvas there to help me out. I'm going to blend in some of this. If you're looking at the reference photo at the same time as I'm painting, it makes more sense what I'm trying to do. And there's this nice little wave back here, a nice little dark something back.
So it's starting to look pretty good. You can almost feel the water lapping up on the shore there. I'm going to put a few more little details in to help it a little bit more. So what I need to do is let this area dry. So I'm going to put a couple little details on this part of the shoreline showing that there's driftwood and logs rolled up on the shore. So that's just with a few little dashes and strokes, kind of randomly, but paying attention in my reference photo where it's darker and got more information, more lines than others. Really not painting that exactly as I see it, but somewhat. There's a really long piece of driftwood. Oop. Right here. That's good. And now what it really needs is some nice white highlights on these bits out here. So I'm literally looking for the highlight shapes. They kind of look interesting. They're on the top of these dark areas. I'm kind of looking for patterns. Just noticing that the white is on top of the dark generally. In some areas it crosses over and kind of does that. In some areas it comes back. These ones come back from the wave. So really you just have to look at your reference photo and look for patterns. Look for shapes that are really unusual that you really want to make sure those particular shapes are in. I notice up here there's like this whole diagonal kind of thing going on. And especially on top of that dark spot. And up here, and these all seem to be going sort of in this direction. So it's not photographic painting, but it's basically just going in the general direction of what the reference photo gives you. And this way you can paint anything. You can paint anything that you take a photograph of, or that you find a photograph of that you like. Had a comment from one of a YouTube watcher who said I didn't know
the anatomy of a wave, which I thought was kind of interesting because waves are so different depending on what angle that you're coming at them. And so the nice thing is you don't need to know the anatomy of a wave. You just have to have eyes and a reference photo and be able to really paint what's the most important bits of the reference photo, not every single thing. Unless you want to paint realism, which is really fun to watch people do too. It's amazing what people can paint when they put their minds to it. But I like to kind of go towards realism and then stop when your eye can pick up and fill in the rest of the image itself. So there is a piece of, I think it must be a piece of driftwood or something, super dark, and it's right about here. I'm going to paint that in. And that's probably the last thing I'm going to do on camera so that this video doesn't get too long. And then I will post my final result as soon as I'm done here. And I hope you enjoyed that. It was a really fun painting to do. Really want to do a lot more reflection, water reflection, sandy beach kind of paintings. So, there you go.
Here's the reference photo that you can screenshot and print and try it yourself. This is how my beach mini canvas painting turned out. I'm pretty pleased with it. Because of where I live, I have many more photos of similar beaches and beautiful places that I'm going to paint next. I'll see you tomorrow for some more mini canvas painting.